Gardening and Crafting with Bernadette. How to use a push planter and how to plant radishes with a push planter. First things first, I'll give you a quick rundown of our Earthway planter. So here's our Earthway Precision Garden Seeder model 1001-B. I just call it the push planter. The height of the handlebars can be adjusted, as you see. The large front wheel is attached to a belt that turns the seed plate, letting the seed drop down the chute, where the cultivar is making a small ditch for the seed. Yeah, you can see that this has been well used and quite muddy. The cultivar is adjustable so that you can get the right depth for whatever seed you're planting. This particular planter has a scale etched into the metal, which is quite helpful, although not foolproof. If the soil is of a certain consistency, the cultivar may go deeper if the soil is very soft, or not go deep enough if it's too hard. The chain behind the cultivar and seed chute covers the seed along with the back wheel. The seed plate is removed by holding the spoke and turning the plate counterclockwise. The thumb hole here helps in turning the plate. As you see, the grooves in the plate and the wheel spoke need to meet up. It's all plastic construction, but has been serving really well for many years. Now I'm putting the radish plate on, so you turn the plate clockwise to lock in place. Often you won't be able to turn the plate all the way to the plastic stoppers, as you see there, little plastic stoppers on the end. All you want is to make sure the plate is secure and doesn't wobble. One last thing, the planter does have a kickstand, although I only trust it on a calm day. Now we come to planting radishes with the push planter. I'm planting Crunchy Crimson and using the medium radish plate as I showed earlier. When dumping the seed in, make sure you don't go above that line. So here's the prepared ground in sandy loam soil. We use a raised bed about 5 feet wide and six inches high, and we mend it with about 1/2 pound per square yard of 19-19-19. While planting, you need to pay attention and make sure that the plate is moving and the seed is coming out. Sometimes a weed or stick may get caught in the belt, or the ground is too wet and clogs up the seed chute and cultivar. And here's a tip, so while you're pushing the planter, tilt the seed toward the seed plate. This helps the plate pick up the seed more easily. So I'll continue to plant, and pretty quickly too. You can see how easy it is with a push planter. And so while you watch me, I can just say a few tips about growing radishes. So if the ground is moist, the radish seed will come up in about 3 days. They should be ready to harvest in about 30 days. This particular variety I'm planting, Crunchy Crimson, is a very sweet and mild red radish. It is actually very, very good all year round. Some radishes aren't because they bolt so quickly during the hot summer heat. So this one is a real good variety for the, planting all year. To keep a steady supply of radishes, you want to make sure that you seed your next planting when your previous planting is about 15 to 20 days old. Don't let your radish bed dry out, because the dry soil tends to produce misshapen radishes. Normally, weeds are no problem because the radishes are ready way before the weeds begin to take over. And there you go. I highly recommend a push planter for medium to large sized gardens, and one of the easiest veggies to grow is the radish. So happy planting! Give me a thumbs up if you can't wait to start gardening again. Subscribe so you don't miss a video. Gardening, art, crafts, and much more. Thanks for watching!